Hello everybody, this is Party PD, and welcome to some more Dota 2, your caster in the KOD League Season 1, or Season 2, Game Number 1, Boar versus Eternity. And we are already straight into the bans here, as we see Boar ban out the Darkseer and the Firebat himself, Bat Rider, and over on the side of the Radiant for Eternity, they ban out the Io and the Slardar. The first pickup for the side of Boar will be the Weaver. Most likely this will be, I want to say a safe lane pick here, because it's a lot of people seem to be picking up Weaver almost instantly nowadays in pro games. Weaver finding a lot of room into some, could be a support Weaver though, but I doubt we're going to see that old bean jumping out of there. That's for sure. Support Weaver, very questionable role. As we only saw it like once, so that is that. And we're gonna see Eternity. I'm gonna take their time to pick here. I guess for those of you who probably noticed, as you can see, the timers are all wrong, because this is supposed to be down there. I don't know when Valve is gonna fix that lobby problem, but the first pickup for the Radiant for Eternity will end up being Disruptor. Very strong support that probably disables Weaver, probably the best out of anybody. I mean, it doesn't break the Lincoln Sphere, but Glimpse, he can Thunderstrike, he can throw down the Glimpse. It cannot be dispelled, except for strong immunity, so for obvious reasons. So Kinetic Field will be able to block the Weaver out and silence him in case for the effect that he'd go invis inside the circle. But when it comes down to it, it's just another good support pickup for the side of Eternity. And looks like they're going to dip into the reserve time to figure out what they want to do as their secondary pickup. An Axe will be the return pickup here. The most likely a jungle Axe or the new offlane Axe. I wouldn't be too surprised if it's in the quote-unquote new offlane. And Shadow Demon will be the return pickup here for the side of Boar, most likely to disable the Axe in mid-call, or disable the Disruptor in mid-silencing field. And there's not really too much else to pick out here. There's not really that much in the pool at the moment. Obviously, the drafts are still extremely unpredictable, but Shadow Demon being able to make it through the first ban and pick phase, going onto the side of Boar, this could just be a Luna, or this could just be a Morphling or something like that to follow up. But they will ban out the Underlord, and Eternity will ban out Underlord. And Boar will go ahead and take some more sweet time. They got more static time if they need it. And we're just going to see what exactly they'll pick up here. Waiting ever so patiently to figure out what exactly they will dip into the reserve time. And they will ban out Drow. So that's just another very strong hero to ban out right now. Super strong in the current game meta and everything like that. So it's not that bad of a ban here, especially since it made it through the first phase. It's also able to just silence the Weaver and the Shadow Demon from using their escapes, so just another silence disabled and removed from the game, so Weaver and Shadow Demon wouldn't be so heavily affected by it. We're going to see Eternity dip into the reserve time here. Figure out what exactly everyone has in mind for their picks and bans. They do ban out the Luna as their secondary ban here in the second phase to make sure that Shadow Demon can't benefit entirely from having one of the strongest illusionary-based push heroes in the game at the moment, being Luna with the illusions from the Shadow Demon. Obviously, the patch made it to where they took more damage, but it didn't stop people from picking Shadow Demon. Very strong pickup still in the current game patch. They did, however, pick up a Axe with the, obviously, Shadow Demon, which is not 100% surprising. Axe could still call out the illusions and not take as much damage. But Sand King will be the return pickup here for the side of Eternity. Just another lineup hero here to go with the Disruptor call, or the Axe call, basically. Disruptor call being the magnetic field. So we're going to go and figure out what exactly the last setups are here. Sand King. Trying to find, pick up here, and they do end up taking up Leshrac, a very strong character. He's not exactly the strongest character, but he is a good one nonetheless. So, Leshrac will be the return pickup here for Sand King. I don't exactly see how this is going to be 100% beneficial. Obviously, they could throw down stuns, and they have more push power with Lesh, but not really something that benefits from being illusioned or Shadow Demon, so on and so forth. So, we're waiting ever so patiently. They're dipping into the reserve time yet again. Eternity. Trying to figure out what exactly Boar's Draft is so far. And I can't predict Boar's Draft either. They have a Shadow Demon, but they don't have, like, the Morphling or somebody that benefits from illusion-based stuff. Eternity, they're dipping into the final of their reserve time. Only 10 seconds left. This is quite an important thing for when it comes to the last stage of the picking. And they will end up picking up Slark. So just another staple hero that can deal quite a bit amount of damage without exactly just being decimated in the laning. Well, no, Slark's pretty decimated in the laning phase, especially against a Leshrac and a Weaver. A lot of pressure that can be applied in the lanes. Boar, they have plenty of time to figure out what exactly they want to do to answer this Slark. They don't really have any silences themselves. They will pick up Timbersaw, so it will counter out the Axe and the Sand King. Mostly Axe, as a lot of Timbersaw's abilities are magic and or pure, if Wombo comboed correctly. But it will drain the strength from Axe, which is the main objective from these team fights. Hopefully just Timbersaw doesn't get called, because if that's so, the pure spins will end up just dealing damage to Timbersaw, and that will disable him from that fight, and Sand King Disruptor. So they will have to time everything perfectly. Timbersaw may be a counter out to the team fight capabilities of Disruptor Sand King. And they will ban out Eternity. We'll use their last ban out for Viper. It was not a random. They have 4 seconds left. And they will ban out the OD. So it's the bans of the mid picks here. And Boar and Eternity still need to figure out what exactly their mids will end up being here. I want to say Queen of Pain is still a viable option for Boar here, but they're just a little bit too squishy. The Timbersaw could be the mid, though. Or the Weaver could be the mid. Who knows? Eternity, though, still indefinitely need a middle character. Or middle hero. They will dip into the reserve time. They have a minute and a half to figure out what exactly they want to do with this reserve time. So they have plenty of time to figure out what exactly they want as their last pick. Again, like I said, Valve has not fixed this whole time bar thing, so it says they have 4 seconds. They as in them, but obviously they do not have 4 seconds. They have a minute over in the reserve time for them. So hopefully Valve will fix that one day, but knowing them, it's going to take a while. So they are going to use up a lot of their reserve time here. 45 seconds left on. I mean, I'm just as question marked as they are. I have no idea what exactly there could be as their mid that would be able to be super beneficial against this team. Most likely something that'd be able to amp more magic damage, but still have a good amount of durability. I want to say Zeus, but he has no durability when it comes to trying to survive in the mid lane. They could do the new Ember Spirit build, where it's just you build magic damage, and in that case, Lesh won't need to get a Veil. That could be the case here with that mid Ember Spirit. That could be another case, though, with Eternity, if they want to do that. But then they'd be running a 4 melee lineup, while Boar. Okay, they are going to run the Shadow Demon, though. That is actually a pretty good pick. It turns team fights around so long as he doesn't get caught out or silenced or anything of that sort. So, and the Queen of Pain will actually be picked up for Eternity instead. So we are going to see the co-op coming into play. So we're going to eagerly await and figure out, because right now they're going through that strategy stage of Dota 2. That's why we don't exactly see them picking their heroes just yet. But yeah, they're just going through the strategy phase, and we'll switch over to having no HUD in a minute. Oh, there we go. And yeah, everyone is out. There's immediately a pause, which will give me time to switch out the thing. There you go. Now it looks all pretty and such. Alright, so as always, I will start with Radiant, not because I like the team more, because I like the Radiant more. Disruptor will be played by Mario, Slark will be played by Wolf, Ush will be on Queen of Pain, We Lost GG will be playing Sand King, and Remy will be on the Axe. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire, we have Lesh being played by MLD, I'm going to just say that. Timbersaw going to be played by Brunt. We have Shadow Fiend being played by Necroman. We have Weaver being played by, I'm going to just say L4. And Mad is going to be on the Shadow Demon. And we'll have everything all set up here. A little 1 minute pause at the very beginning here. This is a best of two, however, so this means nothing up here, except for when it's not best of two and so on and so forth. So hopefully we'll get the game underway here, but very strong lanes so far for both sides of the Radiant and the Dire here. Eternity, I think, might have the upper hand. They have maximum teamfight capability with Slark being their pickoff hero. They can end up running, like us, just going straight into Scream of Pain into, or Sonic Wave. Scream of Pain's the other thing. Scream of Pain could work, too. It's quite a bit of damage. 300, and they don't really have that much magic resistance over on the side of Boar. I mean, they have Shadow Demon. And that's really about it. That's like the most intel resistant hero they've got. These new stats definitely are really annoying to look at. So immediately, wards are going to be picked up. No scouting ability is going to be used. Like nothing Shadow Demon. I think I just heard, yeah, Shrine immediately used in the base on accident. Those things are so easy to right click. I'm not too surprised that automatically, oh, there's another DC. But now we can look at the items going to be built up for some of the heroes if they already have it linked up. Disruptor's going to be the one carrying the ward. Slark going bottle into gloves into a ring of Aquila. Queen of Pain already has an item. Looks like it's six tangos and smoke on the Sand King. So he is going to go bottom. So this is going to be a tri-lane bot with the axe in the new safe lane, basically. And in the bottom, it's going to be possibly tri-lane in the bot. Or they're going to do a rune contest here. It's already Sakuchi spec'd up for the Weaver. Shadow Demon and Lesh have not decided what they want to spec to fight this rune. In fact, even Shadow Fiend is going to come his way too. With the very Diablo-esque set. Wolf does manage to scout out something. Slark, I think, clipped one of the heroes. And Runt is just trying to be a little bit careful. He doesn't know if he wants to sit on that rune just yet. But it looks like everyone's just going to be playing defensively. Ush just really wants this rune. Team scouted out. Mario might be throwing down a sentry. The smoke's going to be revealed. Mad's going to get the stun. MLD, he does manage to get the stun lock in time, but Sakuchi needs to be thrown down if he wants to get the kill. Nope. MLD will end up getting the first blood there. Stun and perfect execution from Shadow Demon will end up getting them the first blood and the bottom bounty rune. So that is three runes going to the side of Boar plus first blood. Sand King will end up throwing a ward, most likely maybe to deny some camps here. No, we don't know just yet. Ush managing to miss the block. It's one creep up in the front, but it looks like it's still fairly even in this mid. We'll go ahead and talk about the lanes, as everyone is now in the lane, except for in the mid, where there could be another possible gank here, as Mad might wants to get the Disrupt done on Ush. But Ush doesn't have Blink Spect. They know that now. And they're going to go turn on him immediately. Disruption's going to be there. Stun going to be queued up. Literally Q. And it's going to be Ush definitely going down here, trying to get himself denied somewhere. One more right click will do it. And that's two kills now going to the side of four here. Shadowfiend getting the other one. Meanwhile, up in the top, though, it is going to be Runt taking quite a bit of damage, trying to tango it out. His regen's not going to be there. And Sand King to get a return kill up in the top, realizing there's no supports up here, so they are going to take him out. Supports now back up into the top lane, though. Resistance is no longer futile. So now we can go ahead and talk about the lanes here. It looks like it's going to be a tri-lane in the top for both teams here for Eternity. They will have Wolf, We Lost, and Mario up in the top with the roaming Shadow Demon Leshrac combination with Runt in the safe slash new offlane. And Axe is actually, I think he's still the jungle by the looks of it. Iron Talon, no massively good regen. Disruption, he's trying to find it on Wolf though, but looks like it's going to be the other way around. Leshrac's going to get stunned up first. MLD, Wolf is slowed. He's not going to be able to get the jump on him just yet. That Windlace early, giving him the enough move speed to run about as Leshrac is a horse, and he's able to just run around and not be contested that hard. Shadow Demon hanging out on the side here, trying to find another setup if he could. Might not find it. Actually, meanwhile, on the bottom, there's a lot of damage going on L4U here. Or L4W. L4. No kills, though. Just a couple good super lucky spins for Remy. Don't think that will actually disjoint it, but he did take a creep hit, so... Oh, no, creep hits don't destroy it anymore. So it does. That did. It's a level 1 dot. Okay, maybe I could finally talk about the lanes. I don't know. It's funny, though, that Axe and the Weaver are in the CS fight here. Axe being in the jungle and Weaver being in the lane. Against a very hard lane, actually. Axe is jungle plus lane, so... Not really that much going on there. Sand King's still carrying that dust. They want to get this creep camp really bad. Get that creep camp. Looks like they're going to find a setup on We Lost. They got to get the stun out now if they want to, but Mario, he's ready. He's ready for a return stun if he needs it. Or not return stun. Actually, he does not even have kinetic field spec'd. So that's a very questionable specking there. Maybe to prevent the future attacks. But nope, doesn't have it spec'd yet. Just has glimpse and dot. So it's 21 and 0 with the Axe and the Weaver 18 and 6 at the bottom, who's now actually at the top looking for an engagement. Not revealed just yet, but Mario, he's going to take quite a bit of damage, but at the same time, stunned up out on the Weaver. We Lost those, taking quite a bit of damage too. The stun's not going to be there. Disruptor trying to TP out. He will end up getting the TP completion, and Timbersaw not to get the confirmed kill. But it still will be one dead. Timbersaw will instead go to the bot lane to fight up against this Axe, who is having practically free farm. Triangle Boot shortly underway. Although I do want to say that it is 3 minutes and they don't have a flying courier just yet. But, No, they do have a flying courier. No, they don't have flying courier. It's still on the ground. Yeah, there it is. Oh, I think it's flying now. Yeah, now it's flying. Looks like they're really trying to get some aggression on Wolf here. The wraparound, though. Smoke on Mario, and We Lost. Looks like they are going to find Necroman. The stun's going to be there. The dot, the damage. Necroman taking quite a bit of damage. He understands he's not going to be able to kill them. Trying to turn on Ush and won't find the kill there. TP rotation from Mad going in, but it was not on time. And it does not end up saving anybody. But now he's stuck in the mid, so he's probably just going to do some mid stuff for a while. No, he's not stuck in the mid anymore. Shadow Fiend instantly to come back. Does have a bottled Arcane Rune and a Raindrop. Just didn't work. Oh no, he just bought the Raindrop. Wolf having a somewhat hard time in the top lane now. Level 4. But only 18 and 2 to the rest of the Dire Heroes that are 27, 6, 24, 13, and 21. Looks like they're looking for another setup here. MLD will find the jump there, but Wolf will jump out himself. L4 to take quite a bit of damage. Meanwhile, though, triple dive that I missed in the bottom here against the Timbersaw. I apologize for missing that kill there. But triple dive from both We Lost and Mario onto the Timbersaw and Axe to get the final. Did he end up using call for that? Yeah, he called, but he didn't Calling Blade. Meanwhile, another wraparound going out here. Mad trying to find another jump on Wolf. They really want to get this one this time. He is going to take the damage buff. And he's going to take quite a huge amount of damage, though. He has another leap. Mad will end up soaking the leap, though. And that is another death going to the way... Or, another death going to the way of Eternity. Another kill going to the way of Boar. At 6 minutes, it's 48-1 on this Axe that even has a kill under his belt. It's quite a crazy lineup here. Top tower getting pushed indefinitely here after that engagement. Not enough mana to throw down another Diabolic Edict. But just enough to... actually, it looks like there could be rotations coming in. Sand King coming in from behind. And a TP coming in from the Disruptor. They do find the Vision Ward up in the corner there. And they will take that out. 100 gold. Looks like it's going to be the Lincoln Sphere. It's going to be the first item for the Weaver. Which is somewhat understandable. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4 Linking Sphere abilities that are going to be quite detrimental to Weaver if they were managed to get off on top. It looks like the setup is still hanging out top. Same thing with... actually, it looks like it's now Smoke with Disruptor. But Sand King going the opposite way. Okay, no, they want to go on the Shadow Fiend again. Level 7, though. They are going to find them. The stun's going to be there. Quap is going to blink in. Takes a little bit of damage, but she has the uphill miss. It will be a glimpse back. Oh, God. The screen misses completely because of the glimpse back, but he's still going to end up going down. The Axe Dot. No disruption might save him at the very end, though, but Weelong is definitely going down here. Axe to get the jump kill on Necro, and it looks like he's not done yet. He wants to go on MLD and MDL, and he does find it. He gets a call, a perfect call. Shadow Demon goes down as well. Perfect rotation for Remy, getting 3 kills uncontested. And that Blink Dagger, literally right around the corner here. They will end up using the Shrine that's actually already on cooldown. So Remy's most likely just going to Tranquil up, actually, and just farm into the next camp. Yep, there we go. He can actually salve now that Creeps no longer break that engagement there. But he does manage to get 3 kills in the mid. We can't let that one slide. He's a 62-1 Axe for CS. And he's already got a Blink Dagger at 8 minutes. What a dirty, dirty Axe. It's going to be a huge problem for the side. Boar here. This Axe having a Blink Dagger so early in there. Their lineup, not really that great when it comes to trying to prevent teamfight engagements. So they are going to have to be a little bit careful here. Stark's still not even running around with that bottle yet. He has his flat boots. And he's going to get some more parts to other things. But he's just not... He's got no items. He just got level 6. Well, maybe a minute and a half ago we got level 6. But this rotation and this stun ability from Boar is actually keeping Slark out of the game. We might as well just go ahead and switch over to the net worth here. We have the Axe, obviously, as predicted, at 4,100 with the Weaver actually running at 3,700 underneath. So Queen of Pain still not having that good of a time, but it looks like the rotations are here. Axe is going to get a perfect call, double call. But he is going to be disrupted, though. MDL is going to take quite a bit of damage. He won't be able to get out for that one. He does get glimpsed back. There is no way for him to get out of this one. Massive amount of damage. He will end up going down as well. The Deny of the Tower, most likely next on Eternity's to-do list. Sand King to get that Deny. But Leshrac and Weaver to go down for the side of Boar. Another just very bad thing for them. Necro maybe wanting to use the Shrine here. Not going to end up needing. He does lose a raindrop charge to the orb. And the smoke's going to go out. Necro, I don't think he's reading the same thing. He just wants to farm. He wants to get this Dragon Lance. I just said lace. He wants to lace this Dragon Lance with laces. But he is just going to rotate onto the Axe here. They want to get a call, but Shadow Fiend, he's coming back. He's got 36 charges. They know he's just camping out right there. Level 6, Timpersaw. He's got the slow availability. They need to do this now, if never. Remy, he is going to be calling out the Axe, but it looks like everything's going to be there. They have the stun to go down, and Remy goes down with a 5 kill streak, going to the Leshrac, actually. So no core is actually getting it there, but he is level 6. He's got wards and 600 gold. And Shadow Fiend's like, I'm done here. I'm going to TP back home into the mid and get my farm back on. And farm back on he will, as he's now contesting his own Weaver at 4.2. He does end up calling in the strength item, but looks like the 3 heroes in the bot right now. Boar really want to get some engagement on here. We Lost is going to find the Shadow Demon, but he'll stun first. There is no detection available. Mad taking quite a bit of damage. Disruption Field's going to slow him down. Axe is going to get the Coaling Blade. It looks like MDL's going to get one too. He's going to end up going down. Double Dunk going down there. And they're not done yet. Remy's like, I got attack speed. I got movement speed. I got everything. And they sided against it. Meanwhile, though, Radiant Structures will be fortified as Necro will push in the mid. Get that one. Top tower to go down as well. And L4 to work on getting his Dragon Lance as well. He can actually get it right now. Most likely saving it just to go to the side shop and pick it up there. It looks like Eternity. They're very content with trying to get this bot tower, though. With the Timbersaw now back in the lane, though, it is a little bit more difficult for Axe to push in. They do have four heroes there, though. And they have their teamfight capability set and ready, except for Wolf Shadow Dance. We are going to see everything going into play here. He's still working on getting his boots. Glove of Haste in his pocket. Dire using Scan. They're figuring out how far back they actually are. And they're not that far back. They're still in the lane. Double damage going to be bottled up on the Shadow Fiend. TP rotations coming in. They want to be a part of this smoke. Radiant, use Scan. They know exactly where they are. They saw the smoke. They read it perfectly. So they are going to have to be a little bit more careful here. Axe might still be kept caught here. They're not too careful. They do know that they're all on the tower. The only person here is not Queen of Pain, and she has a TP to come back if she needs to. But Necro, he's got a DD. He's going to push into the tower. Looks like the setup's going to happen back here. But Remy's going to get a call, though. It's going to save everybody. Disruptor Storm threw people inside of it. And it looks like there is definitely no living there as Ush will get the MDL. And Runt will end up going down to Axe. And Remy trying to get perfect calls here. Matt is going to end up getting the kill instead. L4 going to jump on Mario. Queen of Pain will end up blinking out, though. L4 running extremely low. His rewind is not available. He's going to take a soak from the tower damage. We Lost has a stun. He's going to get one more click. Ush will find it instead. A lot of engagements going on in the bot region at the moment. 13-9 with Eternity leading in kills, but not in tower domination. And obviously, I believe that Boar will have a better late game than Eternity. But we'll see. As both teams are going into a Shadowblade-esque build, despite them having another person that already goes invis from something else. Queen of Pain going into the Blade Mail, so this will be the meme of Pain build, as I'm going to call it. She'll go into everything that makes it to where she gets magic damage and the return damage being up quicker. But we don't know how long it's going to take for her to get to level 25, as Leshrac and the rest of the team is already pushing into the bottom. No heroes in any other lanes. And Necro. They're gonna go ahead and tap this tier 2 tower here. They do have the damage. No DD, but they do have the damage. Looks like there might be some setup here. We Lost. He does not find the Leshrac immediately. He finds him at the last second, but not quick enough. It looks like Remy trying to find something here. MDL, the fortification will be expended for the bot tower. That's good enough for them. Disruption's going to be used. Wolf taking quite a bit of damage. Remy not going to find a call, but it will be Queen of Pain jumping in to get a Scream of Pain off, but not the ult. 22 seconds. Shadow Fiend will get an ult block off anyway. Ush will end up getting the kill. A lot of kills going on here in multiple different locations. Sand King trying to escape here as Boar is just going to try and dominate the rest of the game. They can't quite find him. Oh, they do find him at the last second. The stun would have landed either way, too. Eternity to lose all five heroes finally. Two team fights going on there that I couldn't quite catch. But very, very, very bad for the side of Eternity. A lot of gold going down, a lot of abilities, but actually no one being able to get their ults off and it being that beneficial. Sand King throwing down his ult, but just being disabled near immediately. But all these Axe kills, it's like, even though all these kills are going to Axe, he's definitely not the carry here, so it is going to be difficult for them to keep up the aggro here. They are going to start leaving. The TP is going in. Queen is going to get a scream and kill off Mad. Remy's trying to find a pickoff here, too. A run? Is he going to be able to get out here? He does find the magic escape power to escape. Remy still had the dot on him, but obviously the dot does not stun, so he will be able to get out. Blade Mail also going to be the key item for Axe here with the raindrop to follow. I guess during this period of time, we're at 16 and 14 at 15 and a half, 15 and a quarter minutes with Shadow Fiend leading in the CS as the Weaver leading underneath at 6-9 and 6-2, 6-0 even, basically, on the side of the Radiant for the Queen and the Axe. The Slark, not even near the top, losing to the Timbersaw. Go ahead and talk about items here. Disruptor now has enough mana and money to go ahead and buy his Arcane Boots. He did exactly that. Or did he? I don't think he did. No Courier. No, he did not, actually. He just bought more support stuff. Arcane Boots. It's going to be the plan later, I guess. Slark still trying to go into the Shadow Blade. Looks like it's going to go Shadow Blade into the Echo Saber. Queen of Pain going straight into the Aghanim Scepter, no matter what the case is. Blink Dagger still in the progress for Sand King. And Axe now has the Blade Mail going into the Raindrop next. We're going to have the, not Rod of Atos, we're going to have the Yule Scepter going to be built up for the Leshrac. Bloodstone now built for the Timbersaw. Shadow Fiend going for the BKB. Has Invis, has Dragonlance, has everything he really needs. Now he just wants to live longer. L4. Still going into the Lincoln's Fury. Actually went and decided to build the Dragonlance. Still no boots. It's a very common thing to have a no boots Weaver build. And Shadow Demon just going into more support stuff has a wand and such. So he's buying all the wards. There's nothing exactly happening here. They thought about doing Roshan. Maybe if the DD rune was in the bot or the top lane, but it looks like the rune's already taken. Not on anybody just yet. L4 doesn't have it. Probably Shadow Fiend has it. That's not Shadow Fiend. That's Shadow Fiend. No, Shadow Fiend doesn't have the rune either. BKB. Now under progress here. Looks like they do want to still, they still want to do this Roshan. But with all five heroes top right now on the side of Eternity, I do want to be careful. Five-man smoke, not red. Oh, no, that's their own ward. They made sure beforehand. They do know that the Timber's in the mid. They don't know how much is with the Timber, but they know that Timber's there. Dire Scan, not going to clip anybody. This is going to be a really good jump here if they get it. The Glimpse going back. They are going to find MD. But it's a trade nonetheless for that smoke, but not exactly a trade they were looking for. They probably wanted something else. They didn't end up finding it. Wolf does throw down his ult. Queen of Pain all the way in their base, in their side of the fountain. But it looks like at the same time, it is Axe who's taunted up, going out, and or not Axe, Timbersaw, going to be called out by Axe. The call going to be there. Mad going to get a disruption. Mad low enough to get a chop off. Axe get another dunk going on there. So now they got the trades they wanted. Queen of Pain taking the initiative. Blade mailing, but oh no! Necro just jumping and ulting, not even jumping, just ulting directly on top of Queen of Pain's gonna end up getting kill. Sand King trying to channel his ult, does get it off at the same time. Runt will end up killing off Remy. It looks like the disruption is gonna be there. Runt's not gonna find another kill there, but Disruptor will end up going down to L4. And still, even the trades going their way at the beginning of that fight, everyone just came back so quickly. Timbersaw with that, not near max Bloodstone, but brand new, had so many charges, came back instantly, and was able to kill anything and everything he wanted there. Slark, though, knows that they're in the Roshan, especially since, gosh, Leshrac getting multi-bashed, extremely low health. Oh no, they know, there's a Sentry Ward right in front of them. They're gonna end up getting Wolf as well, getting really low here, and Matt trying to block him off as much as possible. Leap is gonna be there, the Slow is gonna get the kill, MDL is gonna end up getting killed by the Roche because they don't want to lose anyone just yet. Necro, he's going to end up getting we lost as he is dusted. Not dusted, but he's all smoked up into that pit. Ush, he's going to throw up his blade mail. Everyone's back. Remy, they know that the Roshan's extremely low and they want to finish this. Ush taking quite a bit of damage. The Blink is going to be there. And they are going to pop the Shrine. So they got to take this Roshan. They got to take it now. And Roshan will end up going down. It'll go straight to Necro. Looks like now it's still really bad as they gave up more and more heroes in that engagement. 700, 800 gold going to the way of Boar. And it looks like we're not done yet. We have Remy. I gotta get this out of the screen. Oh, it looks like L4 manages to rearm just in time as Remy is gonna take a huge burst of damage from that pure ability. And meanwhile, though, Slark is gonna get a jump on over here. He is gonna find Mad. Mad will end up going down, though. Stun gonna be there for MD. MD trying to find a return stun, though. Wolf getting extremely low. L4 trying to find something. Ush will end up going down, but at the same time, Ush... Oh no, Ush will end up getting MD. Ush will go down instead. After Runt will end up getting the kill there. Disengagement. Now 21-21 even. Still towers indefinitely on the side of Boar here. And Necro with the Aegis. Not to mention the Black King Bar coming in on the courier. 11.7k gold net worth on the Shadow Fiend, who has only Shadow Blade and an Aegis. And the other object, of course. Shadow Fiend trying to figure out if he can grab that Bounty Rune, if it's still there. Grab that BKB, boy, before the courier gets sniped somehow. Will be the pickup here. BKB is up and available. Remy trying to find a call. The Aegis is available, though. Just grab that tower, Remy, and you'll be fine. That dot will disappear in no time. Oh, no, they denied it, though. Slark gets the deny. Axe just toying around with the call ability inside their base. I mean, Axe does have a taunt, but he's just doing that. Looks like he, too, is going to go into a BKB. Disruptor just pulled out his smoke. He wants to go ahead and smoke and trying to get some counter kill as everyone's disengaged. But everyone is long gone. We're going to get this last tier tower here so they can end up getting some more push. L4U is still running around with, or L4W is still running around with no boots. Oh, he does. No, that's not him. Yeah, he's got no boots. This no boots Weaver build, it's literally just relying on Sakuchi 100% of the time. Looks like there is something going on in the mid here. The Aegis is going to be expended for the Shadow Fiend. And it looks like they ain't going to get any kills off of it. But they got the Aegis, but at the exchange of their top tower, possibly. That is the question. Slarky Shadow Bladed up. Oh, he's not, actually. He is going to... The TP is going to go out. Everyone's going to be able to escape. Mario does find a glimpse. It is out on the Lesh track. And Lesh will end up dying indefinitely here. No Yules, no nothing available for him to escape there. L4, though, coming in. The Sentry Ward being thrown down, dedicated. Oh, because the rest of the team is here. Necro's going to end up getting engagement. Meanwhile, on the other side, we have Axe getting perfect calls on heroes over here. And Necro getting perfect kills over here. And it looks like Axe, he's not done yet. No, Axe is done. Runt trying to find an engagement here. Meanwhile, at the same time, Wolf is trying to escape. He is going to end up having to Shadow Dance out. They will end up using the Shrine. Everyone's back at full HP. Are they going to find somebody? L4 runs right into Remy. Remy gets a perfect call off. Blademail's going to be there. No dot's going to be available. Scream! It will be there. L4 will end up going down from the Scream from Queen of Pain. Sonic Wave. MD is not going to be able to find the stun here. Ush is already long gone. And Weaver to go down, but the Shrine's now available for destruction. It's going to end up being pinged down by MD and Necro. You can see the item progression here. I don't know exactly what Shadow Fiend's going to be building into next. He could still do the Force Pike, or he could go into the... Already has Silver's Edge, so can't do that. Let's go ahead and figure out what everyone's going to build here. Disruptor's still running around with nothing on him, just boots and wards and such. We got Slark, who is still trying to build his Echo Saber, and instead looks like he's going to go into the Silver's Edge as well. Queen of Pain going into the Orchid? Malevolence. Yeah, it is going to be the Orchids, and King does have a Blink Dagger picked up just recently. And Axe still going into the BKB, Leshrac, whoever. The Yules is coming in. Actually, looks like something's going on here. Break! Oh, does not get the last hit in there. Necro not able to kill off that Disruptor. Needs a little bit more damage. That Force Pike might have been able to do it, but I don't know how much more damage it actually gives you. So that's what that is. Leshrac going into the Yules has it now. Timbersaw has the pipe. Most likely he's going to go into the Boots of Travel. Shadow Fiend could bat Boots of Travel as well. Weaver, Deso, I believe, is on the to-do list here. He's got one hammer in his backpack and one hammer in the base. Eventually in the base. Radiant using scan, not going to find anybody as they just now are showing up in their lane here. And we're waiting ever so patiently. Don't know what exactly is going to go on. Everyone are just going to go back to farming. There's 14,000 on the Shadow Fiend that's just running around with like a gold mine on him. He's going to go into the Aghanim Scepter. So not that bad of an idea there. Able to get the technically double ult off. The heal and the kill ult. will be the Odesso that is now built up on the Weaver. Got a lot of move speed. 360 move speed. Looks like the smoke is going to be used up over here somewhere. If somebody has one. Mario does have one. So Mario, are we going to smoke up? They walk over a sentry ward, but that's nothing. They do get the scan. Mad does find Ush. The Ush is just right-clicking, actually. He's got a lot of right-click damage. Mad will end up going down, but Runt at the same time will get Ush. Sand King is going to be able to get the stun off Runt. Dust is used for... We lost. Or, no, he used Dust. I think that was supposed to be his Force Staff or something like that, but he doesn't have one. MDL to end up getting the kill off of that one. So, two going down for the price of one. The Shadow Demon, in fact, not even that much of a trade. They will find this ward here. So, they do manage to get a counter ward immediately into the fight. Meanwhile, in the mid, we have Axe taking quite a bit of damage. The DD on Necro, he ain't afraid to right-click Remy. But he will not find the kill there. That wasn't ult, actually, as well, so his ult is down for another 90 seconds. He does have the Aghanim Scepter approximately halfway there. He is just going to throw everything into his inventory here to make sure he gets the maximum regen from this shrine. This Shadow Fiend having quite an easy time in the game right now. He's going to end up going to the Aghanim Scepter. I've already talked about this like 9 times, but it's pretty important as the Aghanim Scepter is double ult. Or it's like a 1.5 in a sense that makes it to where he just heals when it comes back in. So it's really beneficial. Actually, something I didn't talk about at all during this game, which we should be, is talent tree builds, as we have the Disruptor going for 100 cast range, which is pretty good. 60 gold per minute on the support like him. First tower finally going down. At the same time, Wolf taking quite a bit of damage. Not gonna get pinged up there. Shadow Fiend not gonna find him either. No one's running around with a gem, though. Shadow Fiend, he's waiting. He's still Silver's Edged. And he won't find anybody there. So he's just going to go ahead and cut out this wave. And get the easy CS. Some more souls, even though he doesn't need them. They know that he's down there, though. The TP going to be used. The smoke won't trigger. So that is a wasted smoke. Okay, talent trees. Actually, hang on. Ush is going on engagement in the top, though. Perfect timing with that Yules, though, is going to save Lesh for only a couple seconds. Glimmer Cape going to be the next pickup here. Ush, he does manage to pick up the Orchid Malevolence. He's just going to TP out, though. He doesn't want to risk anything just yet. There's a smoke in the mid. Necro walks right on top of them, but nobody knows. They're like, oh god, I just revealed everybody. So, everyone's going to go ahead and leave from that engagement. Act like nothing ever happened. Except for, you know, Disruptor having no HP. That was quite an interesting encounter. Shadow Fiend walking on top of the enemy, finding out that they're there at that exact second. Ush! He is trying to break the Lincoln, so L4 will end up going down easily. Necro, though, he's coming in. He wants to get a jump on. They think that he's gemmed. Actually, the rest of the team is here. They want this. They want this bait going on. Ush, he's got to get hit by that double soul walk-in, walk-out. But Remy actually gets his blink canceled by the clip of that Requiem and is not able to go in there and save Queen. BKB is available for Remy, however. He does want to save for the buyback. Necro, the Aghanim Scepter coming in. He wants to go on Remy so bad. BKB, Disruption's going to make sure that Shadow Demon ain't going nowhere. We lost. This is definitely going to go down here. He's taking quite a bit of damage. MDL to get the confirm. Disruptor Storm, not really going to be able to do anything. Maybe opens up a little bit of space. L4 getting low. But Wolf, though, takes a huge chunk of damage. Ush to do the buyback. Call going back in. It will be definitely Lesh going down here. Axe to get the call. That extra move speed is available if they needed it. Silenced out on the Shadow Demon. They think that somebody went to this side, but nobody is over there. Nobody's there. L4. They saw that Wolf was smoked up. It's going to be the Scotty, though, that's next on the to-do list for the Slark. So, okay, back to the whole talent trees thing. We have Slark that ended up going for 15 agility and 10% lifesteal at the very beginning instead of more damage, which might actually be a 50-50 for him, but it's okay. It's 10%, which isn't that bad. 10% is still quite a bit. Looks like they end up using a smoke to go straight into the Roshan pit here. But it looks like the Eternity are reading that fairly effectively. Necro, you're going to want to... There you go. You want to step in there a little bit more. Eternity might be reading that fairly effectively as the rest of the team... Okay, they didn't read it fairly effectively. They will end up getting the Aegis out on Necro. And they want to find some engagement while they're here, but they're not around. Scan still available. Speaking of which, the Radiant will now use a scan to figure out if there's anybody at that bounty rune, which is here. But that is not the case. Everyone is in the mid. Shadow Fiend, though, illusioned up by the Shadow Demon. Oh, no, that's his own. They are going to go straight into this bottom, though. Everybody TPing back in except for the Queen of Pain, who is now TPing back in. They want to get this bottom tower and finish off the rest of the game here. MDL, Sentry Ward going to be thrown down. Axe is going to get the perfect call. Not exactly perfect, as Shadow Fiend will take quite a bit of damage, though. Remy will be L4 jumping in at the same time. There's two fights going on at two different locations. Shadow Fiend ult's going to find one kill. Everyone's extremely low from that Shadow Fiend drop. Everyone has buyback, though, available, except for the Sand King, who died in the back against L4. And these bot barracks are going down fairly quickly, though. Remy just showing off his fresh BKB. What's that going to do when Necro is just going to wail on you with his massive amount of damage? Scream going out. It will land on RNT, but he's got 14 seconds until he's back, so that's going to be an easy comeback for them. And they are going to go straight into these mid barracks. A lot of buybacks being dedicated for that. And Axe still to end up going down one of those very buybacks. So they have a lot to. They have a lot of open space right now. Queen of Pain ult not available. L4. Lincoln's is popped. Deso still available on him to deal enough damage. Lesh, though, extremely low. He will end up going down here. There is no exception to that. But at the same time, Queen of Pain broke. Nope, that'll be the mid-racks as well. Will they go for the top? No, they're done. They're done. Shadow Fiend still has the Aegis. Meanwhile, though, L4. Oh, perfect glimpse back. He is going to run on top of a Sentry Ward, though. Oh, no, there's no Sentry Ward there. But L4, there is no escape for him there. He will end up going down as well. He has 5 grand on him, and somehow the Radiant... only get 600 of that 5 grand. It looks like it's a fairly certain game here. As Boar, they're definitely boring into the enemy base. And they made their mark. They ended up getting 2 barracks off this exchange: a buyback from the Axe and a buyback from the Queen. A dieback from the Axe, actually. But being such a low level on this Axe is... he's not actually a low level, but I think he went respawn time. No, there's no respawn time for Axe. He went for more health. Dire, though. They now have all their outer tier 1s dead, if that means anything at this point. Shadow Fiend, looks like it's going to be the Satanic next on the line here. Courier is probably bringing in... that's Satanic. No, that's not Satanic. What is that? No, that's Satanic now. Satanic doesn't need the Helm Dominum. Courier, though, just swings by the team. The smoked up team. Courier is going to clip back and end up getting clipped probably by somebody. This Courier flies right on in. Drops off the items to the Satanic. The Courier, though, not going to be scouted out entirely. They don't want that Courier. Necro, he's invis. The smokes are, the reveal's going to be there, though. The call is out. Lesh is definitely going to go down here. As Remy, though, he's trying to deal enough damage. Necro does end up popping down his ult. The blade mail, though, on somebody. Necro is going to live for sure in this engagement. He still has the Aegis as well. This is a perfect engagement for them. If Necro is managing to still get kills. Sand King extremely low. They are going to pop the indoor shrine. Or indoor shrines, plural. Aegis... still available on Necro. Whether or not they want to continue to push in, though, is up to them. The Satanic is sitting in Shadow Fiend's inventory. He's waiting. He wants to die so he can end up putting this damn ability, this thing, on his actual bar of items. Stun gonna be there. We lost. He does have a ult available if he wants to try and do something here. Necro, though, he's like, kill me! He does end up finally going down, though. Wolf, there's a lot of damage burst going out to him. There's no buyback available on that bad boy. And Shadow Fiend is gonna end up putting up that Satanic in there, and he's gonna deal so much damage to this Queen. Blade Mail, not gonna mean anything when Necro comes down the lane. It's going to be the GG going out by Eternity as Disruptor is taking damage inside their own base. But that is that is Boar claiming game number one at 34 and 32 at 35 minutes and 50 seconds, which is actually 49, but whatever. It will be Boar to claim game number one. Game number two shortly underway.
This is so exciting. I can't believe it's actually happening.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It all just happened so fast.
Yes. Yes, it did.
And the timing? It couldn't have been more...
perfect?
Yes. I just can't keep this inside of me anymore. I want to show the world.
Why don't we show them right now?
This just feels so... right. That looks fantastic.
We're always happy to help. Thanks for calling Bluehost.com.
Hey, who are you talking to, sweetie?
Just a Bluehost tech helping me get my website off the ground.
Trained experts available to every Bluehost customer 24/7.
Place your bets on more than 15 esports games using the worldwide payments and even Bitcoin. We offer 24/7 support and bonuses for every new user. Best esports bets on gg.bet.
Делай ставки на более чем 15 игровых кибердисциплин с использованием всех популярных платежных систем, включая Bitcoin. Круглосуточная поддержка и бонусы новым пользователям. Делай ставки на киберспорт на gg.bet.
This is so exciting. I can't believe it's actually happening.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It all just happened so fast.
Yes. Yes, it did.
And the timing? It couldn't have been more...
Perfect?
Yes. I just can't keep this inside of me anywhere. I want to show the world.
Why don't we show them right now?
This just feels so right. That looks fantastic.
We're always happy to help. Thanks for calling Bluehost.com.
Hey, who are you talking to, sweetie?
Just a Bluehost tech helping me get my website off the ground.
Trained experts available to every Bluehost customer 24/7.
Place your bets on more than 15 esports games using the worldwide payments and even Bitcoin. We offer 24/7 support and bonuses for every new user. Best esports bets on gg.bet.
Делай ставки на более чем 15 игровых кибердисциплин с использованием всех популярных платежных систем, включая Bitcoin. Круглосуточная поддержка и бонусы новым пользователям. Делай ставки на киберспорт на gg.bet.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to some more Dota 2. This is your caster, Party PD, for the KOD League Season Number 2, Eternity vs. Boar, Game Number 2. As we see here, the bans and picks are already going about, as we already have the first set of bans, as basically the exact same as last time, except Underlord being in the first set. Leshrac will end up being the first pickup for the side of Eternity, but let's talk about these bans. It's Io and Underlord that were banned out for the side of Eternity, and from Boar, they ban out the Slardar and the Darkseer. So, very strong characters banned out immediately. Obviously, this patch has just recently started, so some teams may not exactly know what is the best powerhouse character yet, but of course, everybody still hates OD, and I equally hate OD as well. So we'll just let that one slide. We'll leave my hate to myself. As Eternity will pick up Leshrac first, and Boar will take Weaver again. Right? Yeah. They had Weaver last game. Yeah. So they will end up taking Weaver again, and Rubick to be the return to pick up here from Boar. As they did give Eternity the first pick here. And Lesh managing to be the first pick for the side of Eternity, and Axe being the return pick up here. Just they love Axe, durability, disable, technically, and Rubick over on the side of Boar, maybe to steal some spells from the Leshrac. And the return ban out from Boar here will be the Nyx Assassin. Nyx being a fairly strong character in this patch at the moment. A lot of the offlane characters, offlane heroes, I'm not from Heroes of Norrath, I should not say characters, otherwise I'll be shot by somebody somewhere. Anyway, heroes, banned out. Nyx Assassin is one of the better ones that benefits from this new offlane, is actually better than safe lane meta, and it will be Eternity that's going to ban out the Undying next. Maybe we'll see some unique picks going out from Eternity and Boar, now that Eternity have the Lesh and the Axe, and Boar now running Rubick instead. Maybe we'll see some unique bans. Who knows? Other than the unique bans we've already seen. It will ban out the Shadow Demon. Boar just doesn't really like to deal with that, especially since last game, Boar had it, but they didn't really benefit from using it as often as they would like. Maybe they just wanted to disable the Leshrac plus Disruption combo, and they didn't want to take it themselves when it comes to their picking phase. But the Dire are going to head, Eternity are going to figure out what exactly they want as their last ban. Before we go into the next pick phase, of course. dipping into the reserve time here. It looks like the teams are a little bit more sparing with their reserve time this time around. No, we're waiting ever so patiently to figure out what eternity want to do. Just at the same time, I said it looks like teams are more sparing with their reserve time. I actually lied, as we have eternity dipping into it pretty heavily with 25 seconds with 1 minute left. So minute 25, obviously, I'm really stuttering right now. Don't know why. Looks like I lied. I definitely lied, as eternity are really, really thinking about fine-tuning this. They just don't want to deal with that Shadow Fiend again, so they ban it out. Maybe they were thinking of using it themselves, which is probably why they took a while to end up figuring out what they want to do with that. And looks like Drow will be the pickup for Boar here. So we are going to see the Dirty, Dirty Drow line up for Boar. And that's it for that one. So obviously Eternity might want to pick things that are good counteracting this Drow lineup. Massive amount of damage that comes out from the rest of the team on the side of Boar is going to be quite an annoying thing to deal with. Next thing you know, Boar will pick up a Huskar, and then that's pretty much game over there. Huskar just such a dirty, dirty hero. But Eternity will dip into the reserve time yet again, dipping down most likely to the 1 minute mark before they end up picking up something. Man, I am not on a roll today with gambling and guessing when they're going to do the thing. But looks like Eternity, I don't know exactly what they want to do to counter out this Drow lineup. Maybe some sort of another initiation character, a Centaur Warrunner, could be a very good viable pickup here, or something that just disables Drow Ranger. And it looks like they're going to pick up the Earthshaker, so just a very stun-heavy character hero. Oh my gosh. Another very stun-heavy hero that's going to end up dealing quite a bit of damage to the enemy team here, as so far everyone's pretty squish. And will benefit massively from being able to blink in and getting those multi-man Echo Stomps. It's just called Echo Slam, but Echo Stomp, whatever. Echo Stomp is Elder Titan, so that's what that is. That was my foot. We're going to wait for Boar to figure out what exactly they're going to continue to do here. We don't know exactly what the plan is here. As is a Drow lineup, so they're trying to figure out what exactly they want to do. Do they want to run a Vengeful Spirit? Or not Vengeful Spirit. What? Not Vengeful Spirit. Visage. The weirdest and oldest character in Dota 2. And by that, I mean he's definitely beneficial in the sorts, but He's just a question mark hero when it comes to whether or not they want to set it up with a Visage. But Visage was one of the people back then that benefited massively from a Drow lineup, so I wouldn't be surprised if they pick something along those lines. But we're seriously dipping into the reserve time. They'll pick up Clockwork, actually, so that's their initiation, which I've seen a lot coming out from Drow lineups, as Clockworks are usually the ones to follow up with the Drow lineup. So they have some sort of engagement. So it looks like Ember Spirit will be the return pickup here. Massive amount of technical magic damage. This could be the meme spirit. This could be the magic damage spirit, where they could just go into the multi I'm always going to chain you spirit kind of thing. And I don't know what the lineup here exactly is so far. Boar, they still have another pick here, but they could really run almost any of these heroes mid except for Clockwork. And they ban out the Lifestealer despite only having one strength hero. I mean, magic immunity and on command is kind of a big one. And it looks like Queen of Pain will be the ban out from Eternity. So, Boar, they think they're trying to look for a mid still. Most likely it is going to be that case, though. Maybe an offlane Huskar, Drow in the mid, and Weaver in the safe. Who knows? Eternity. They have plenty of things to decide here and what exactly they want to do here. They do have 40 seconds reserve time. I wouldn't be surprised if... No, I can't see a Huskar on the side of Eternity, but something that just does more armor, that's still durability. Not really a Timber Saw, but Timber could work, draining the max stat of whatever hero he decides to attack at that point in time. Oh, Luna. Okay, I could see that being a very viable pickup here. Magic damage, physical damage, just being a very strong setup for them, especially since Luna could just ult in and most likely jump on all these heroes. We could see a Luna doing Blink after, maybe it's the Aether Cannon build, who knows. Aether Cannon, yeah, it's the Aether Cannon build where you just, you Aether, and then you use your ult on somebody that can jump in for you. And at that point, it's just so much magic damage that you're overwhelmed. So Boar, they have 30 seconds on top of their 20-something seconds they already used up to figure out what exactly they want to do to counter out this lineup. I want to say it's a pretty squishy lineup again, but not exactly. Eternity definitely have the lead on initiation capability, and they do pick up the Silencer. So Silencer, most likely the mid against this Ember Spirit, as I am going to predict it will be the Ember Spirit in the mid. So we're eagerly awaiting to figure out... Oh, actually, we're not waiting anymore. At this point, they're doing the whole, like, strategy phase, so that's what we're waiting on, where they're going to go and what they're going to do. Of course, they're a team, so most likely they already know what they're going to do. That was the whole, like, point of the drafting stage. Yep. This is probably the most important part about casting now, is waiting for the people to get into the lobby like that. Alright, looks like we can move around perfectly fine. A pause going to be initiated immediately, which allows me to switch the HUDs back around with ease. So, as always, we will start on the side of the Radiant. Now we have Boar on the side of the Radiant. MDL will be on Weaver. L4 will be the Drow Ranger. Necro will be piloted by Silencer Mad. On the Rubik and Runt will be the Clockwork. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire, we have Leshrac being played by Mario. Remy will be on the Axe yet again. Ush will be on the Ember Spirit. We Lost will be on the Earth Shaker. And Wolf will be on Luna. And we eagerly await to figure out where the people are going to go for lanes here. I'm very question marked when it comes to Boar's lineup here. Figuring out what exactly what heroes are going to go where and how they're going to benefit from going wherever they are. I mean, it's probably just going to be Clockwork offlane. And then, that's pretty much it. Clockwork offlane, roaming Rubik. MDL in the safe, Necro in the mid. L4 in the safe. Oh, this is actually very question marky. Is this a support Weaver? Please, no. Is this a support Weaver? This is not support Weaver. MDL played Core last game. Didn't he? MDL was the Lash last game. Oh, this might be support Weaver. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Might be support Weaver. Wraith Band is going to be the recipe in Drow Ranger's pocket. Rubik running around with a smoke. No wards, actually. Oh, he already threw them down. Looks like that's it right there. That's it right there. Those stock ward skins. Ew, who placed that? Oh, you can't see who placed the ward anymore. Yeah, that's dumb. Hey, wards have 300 movement speed. They can move if they wanted to. Anyway, looks like we are going to go into the lanes here. It looks like Wolf might be the mid instead of the Ember Spirit. Wolf's just scouting. And Ush is going to end up grabbing the Bounding Rune. Ush mid, that makes sense. So MDL, L4 just doing his emote. Necro on the Silencer, Rubik on Mad, and Clockwork running as a Runt. This is the pretty much offlane Clockwork. It's just going to try and cogs out the tower here. He's going to wait until he gets most of the creeps and then cogs. Like, right there would have been a good one. He wants to get it perfectly. Try to get all four of them in there. He does manage to lose one. But he blocks himself, actually. He can't deny that in order to block the second set of creeps. So those creeps will be able to progress into the lane fairly easy. Don't know how much it's going to block there. Will be the silencer mid. Why is that courier unusual? It is indeed a support weaver. Ush, though, extremely low. The courier is going to get sniped, though. MDL, one more tower hit, and he's dead. Ush to end up getting the first blood at the exchange of the tower, or at exchange of the courier there, though. Silencer getting low as well. He is going to take just a slide of fist to the face, but misses the chains, actually. Oh, he didn't have mana. No, yeah, he missed the chains. But the stun's going to be there. Necro, are they going to dive this or not? Ush to get the confirmed kill again. Mario getting low. I think he actually is just going to deny himself. Ush getting low, too. Taking dot damage from something. Oh, he might have had one of the swarms on him, and it just didn't register. No, no swarm. They are going to end up using the shrine extremely early, which is not actually a bad idea, as the regen is fairly good extremely early, and they could just easily redo this whole mid lane engagement and get yet another steal. So we can go ahead and talk about the lanes here, as we have Weaver being a roaming support, which is still 50-50 about, and Clockwork in the off lane against the safe lane Axe, which is technically the new off lane. Actually, hang on, looks like an engagement going on here. Maddie's in the bad spot here. Mario, he's going to land. No, he's not going to land the stun. He's lifted. He's going to do the stun now. He doesn't need to do it. Mad will end up going down to Wolf. Not a very eventful kill there, but still a kill nonetheless. Waiting ever so patiently. Three kills over on the side of Eternity. Looking good for them so far, which is definitely something compared to the last game. But they do have an Ember Spirit, and they are going to find this regen rune. There's no bottle up on the Ember Spirit, though, but it denies the regen of Necro, who might get jumped on here. No, he is actually just going to throw an Arcane Curse on Ember Spirit. Shield to be dispersed nigh immediately. Meanwhile, though, in the bot, Mario manages to get a kill on L4. Another kill I just managed not to see. I miss one or two every now and again. Mario, though, he's getting chain stunned. Or just chain blocked by all these creeps. And MDL is going to be able to get that capitalized kill. So first kill finally going to the way of Boar will be the Mario hero. Smoke going to be picked up for Mario. He might want to roam in yet again. You want to smoke on top of everybody here. The ward might actually see him if he was to do it extremely close. And they are just going to go around. They do know that the supports are leaving the lane, though. So with that ward there, it will be kind of difficult for Mario. And we lost, end up getting a rotation. Oh, they want to use the shrine. I think that's what's going on here. Oh, no, that's not. It's just the courier going back. Looks like in the top, though, Runt extremely low. Remy trying to get a dive. No dot available. He's going to go straight into Vanguard. We lost extremely low. They want to go ahead and use the shrine. Mario wants to get in on that action, too. But it looks like they want to try and deny that shrine usage. MDL, though, coming in. It is going to be a support Weaver, as he's going to go into the... stun. Not going to be there. The invis is going to be picked up by MDL. Oh, Ush extremely low. One more right click from Necro is going to be there. But MDL gets the confirm instead. Question is, did Necro get the ult steal or the int steal? That is a negative. So still beneficial, obviously. MDL getting the kill there on the Ember Spirit. But no int steal available for that one. And Luna is free farming. I'd say that, but she's 11-1, so she's still having a hard time being in the lane against this Drow and MDL. Speaking of hard time, she is literally just going to get jumped on by every stun possible here. And already the Medallion of Courage showing some great power. -7 armor so early in the game at 5 minutes. Runt, though, he is going to get jumped on by Mario. Mario will not land the stun. Means Remy has got to get back. That's what that is. It still will be the Vanguard. It's the first item for Axe. He's not going jungle. He doesn't have the Iron Talon. But it looks like a 5-hero rotation. Going into this top. They want this Clockwork. Clockwork doesn't want anything about it. Stun, it's actually going to land. TP rotations are going to be there, though. There's one coming in. It is the support Weaver. Runt is going to end up getting the drop off, though. Runt will end up getting killed, though. But we lost. The Earthshaker dropping down a totem just in time. Axe, where did you end up TPing, brother? You went to the bottom. It was like, it's time to rotate Clockwork. Go, No, wait, who was the bottom? Oh, it was Luna. Okay, so Luna's in the top now. Free farming it up. A good change that's definitely beneficial. Obviously, Axe on the brink of getting that Vanguard. It's going to have a pretty easy time in the bot against the Drow. Well, I say that, but minus 7 armor from the Weaver already running about. This tower, though, might get the exchange rate here as Leshrac's going to try and right-click into it. Now he's got to go. Diabolic Edict doing double damage to towers is pretty amazing, guys. Just want to say, it deals 40%. It's still basically double damage. But it looks like in the middle, though, Silencer is stunned up, but he's going to try and just right-click Ush down. He knows he could do it. One more click will be there. And he ends up getting it. Necro Man getting extremely low. The Insap is going to be there. Necro, he is going to get low. We lost. He's going to get the kill. But at the same time, Mad trying to dive. There is so many dots on both of them right now. Mario going down as well. A double kill going for MDL. The support Weaver getting a double kill. And he's just going to go ahead and rotate out. He's level 5. He's about to get level 6. Not really about to, but that is 2 kills going to the way of the roaming support Weaver. Oh gosh, roaming support Weaver, just actually doing good. Vanguard going to be picked up, and the Clarity going to be used up as well, since it no longer gets interrupted by creeps. The Wolf in the top, he is going to get hooked. Clockwork, though, free easy kill, trying to get the stun off on MDL, but not going to find it. Obviously, with that minus 7 armor, it would have taken a lot more damage to that beam. But just not there. Clockwork stuff doing the damage. Radiant using scan. Smoke's going to go out. Looks like they're going to rotate into the jungle to try and find somebody. But maybe they want to try and find Necro as he's not showing in the mid. Oh, they're going to go around the bot. Go ahead and jump on L4W. Finally! Looks like the Dire are going to use the scan. They find nobody. Scan is there. L4. Axe does find them, though. Silence is going to be there. There's nothing that actually... Oh, never mind. Mario will end up getting the stun. Wolf there to confirm it as well. Remy, though, will end up getting the Axe call down onto L4. And that is a free kill going to them. The Drow Ranger, practically free farming, finally answered as 43-7 at the CS at the first death. 7-7 even with the tower advantage. I'd say probably going in Eternal once they get one of these towers. All of them extremely damaged. Oh, except for the mid, I think. Yeah, mid's fine and off, and bot's like perfectly fine. But a lot more rotation capability going out by the enemy team. Ush, though, pops a shield at the last second, giving Arcane Curse another proc. And I think that'll tear through the shield at the last second. No, it's got like 100 charge left, yeah. And Ush is just going to get right-clicked down. These glaives are pure damage, so it's a lot of damage. It's a lot of damage. So you see the Dire Heroes rotating in. The smoke is not available, so this is a blind jump. And that ward finds him perfectly. In fact, so perfect that Runt's already in. The Global Silence is going to go down. It looks like Earthshaker is definitely the main one to be traded here. Axe Call, though, is going to find at least one taunt. Double Stun going to be there going out. The pull down from the Rubik going to be there. Bomb going out by the Ember Spirit, but he's on the wrong side of the cogs. He actually is going to get bursted down here. One more right click will do it. And that is the Int Steel going out there. So double kill on MDL yet again. This roaming support Weaver doing quite the damage. He's going to be able to purchase his ring. And he is maybe buying back Black Boots. Mario, though, stunned up. One more click will be there. Monster kill to get the... MDL to get the monster kill. MDL, though, now dotted up by the by Remy. Call is going to be there. No, it's not, actually. No mana available for the call. This is actually really bad. L4 gets the silence. The slows are going out, though. Remy trying to get on top of somebody. The mana is there now after the millions of wand charges. Remy, though, will end up getting the drop down on the 8 kill streak MDL. And Remy, though, he's going to get another one. L4 extremely low. One more right click is going to end up killing him. And the axe call. He's got mana to do it. He's going to do it. There it is. So another kill going out to him as well. And the Luna ult to finish off yet another kill. Does not find Necro, though. As Necro is invis. The flare is going to go out. It does not find We Lost, who is running at no HP right now. Necro trying to find him. Oh, he sees him at the last second. He wants that. He's like, super juicy kill here. No HP. Invis rune does not give you move speed, though, so he is not able to jump on top of them efficiently. Swarm is going to go out. It is going to be right-clicking down. Wolf is going to get wailed on by MDL. MDL rearming. Runt not able to get the jump on here. He doesn't have his cogs available just yet. He needs to turn on his flares in order to get something going, though. Remy's going to get a dot, and the shrine was available. Remy is going to get the call, and Runt is going to take quite a bit of damage here. Will be able to get out, though. Silenced up. Remy is going to go down with a 3-kill spree. MDL, they're looking for more blood here. Ush, he's got a remnant available somewhere. It's all the way back here, but there's heroes waiting on top of that remnant. So, looks like Eternity, they're not really doing too well here. I still have the CS chart loaded up for some reason. Axe, just like last game, on the top of the net worth at 4-7. Oh, Ush, though, he does manage to reproc the shield. The firebomb's going in. They can't get that, oh god, they did pop the shrine at the last second, but he wasn't there for it. Wolf, though, taking quite a bit of damage. Not going to be contested exactly there. The shrine usage, so close, but yet so far. Ember Spirit to fall to MDL as well. The support Weaver actually doing some crazy damage going into boots now. Super crazy damage. And the beautiful shrine usage. Everyone getting practically back to full mana. And another smoke. It might have been exposed, though, as Necro does manage to walk into the lane and right-click. It looks like they want to go for this mid yet again. Everyone's all lined up. Runt, he's got his ability ready. That's his R ability. He does manage to try and prep the flare. The global silence is there, and that's the dead We Lost GG. Going down. Mario's still in the mid, though. The clockwork flare does find Mario. The hook not going to be there. Just barely misses it. This might be a blink dagger from the Lesh. Probably not, though. And everyone is just going to go ahead and wail on this mid tower. Weaver, his boots are coming in. The support Weaver doing some crazy damage. Blink is available. It is going to be a call. It is going to be called up on two different people right now. Double spin's going to be there. Runt's going to end up getting a kill in the background, as well as Necro getting the tower. Wolf getting a tower somewhere. But immediately, L4 getting decimated there. Steel is going to be there. It was just the Q. But everyone is going to get back out here. Clockwork Flare going out just in case as well. Counter confirmed some damage there. They did end up losing the Drow, but at the same time, they managed to get a tower in alternative lane. Oh no, they did get the Lesh as well. So not that bad. But the perfect call going out by the Axe ended up confirming the counter kills there. And all is quiet and all is well as MDL will push down the mid yet again. Necro bottling up a haste rune. The clockwork hook not going to find any targets yet again. The smoke, though, Remy, he's going to find a call here. He finds Necro, but he is stunned immediately as soon as he goes in. But Necro getting still extremely low. One more click will be there. He's actually trying to haste out. And he will end up living. Meanwhile, Runt getting a kill out on the Earthshaker. MDL getting low. But the Drow is back up available. Remy, he is going to end up going down. The stun was available to silence the Wolf ult. L4W. Wolf getting extremely low. Two more right clicks will do the trick, though. MDL trying to find it. Rooted up. Drow does end up popping another rune there. But MDL will end up getting the kill in the background. Ush to go down as well from L4. And the mid tower to go to Necro, who ran away with no HP and back and ready for the fight yet again. 19 and 11, 15 minutes even, and then tier 2 tower is already being chipped down. 6.1k out on the silencer and 5.7 out on the Drow. This support Weaver. Not even a dirty hero in that sense. Just so strong. So strong. Being able to get the minus 7 armor so early. He is going to need to go invis again. He gets taunted up. This is a dead MDL. Axe to get the 4 kill streak there. Now he's at 6-1 though. That's Weaver. It's support Weaver. He's at 5.5. He's doing amazing. Remy will end up getting the call though. Manages to get the creeps. He's on the wrong side though. Run will end up going down. That's a 4 kill streak. Maddie's in a bad place as well. Necro though, the silence is there, the global silence to follow. Necro, he's like, I'm turning this ship around. Last track will end up going down and Mario to get the confirmed kill. Meanwhile, Runt's going on top of Wolf. Definitely not an exchange they want to get going on here. There was there a buyback? I did not see. There was not, so we're fine. Necro and Wolf to go down. Or Necro to get the kill, Wolf and Leshrac to go down. Global silence, though, was used, mostly defensively, but they want to try for this mid tower yet again. No, they're not. They might just do Roche. Oh, regenerate on the Necro. Okay. That's all they wanted to do there. We can go ahead and talk about some of the skill tree builds. It's 30 plus Sakuchi damage for the Weaver, so I always do that personally, support or not. We lost. Still trying to go for that Blink Dagger. Always so close, but always so far. Drow Ranger will end up going for the 5 more stats. 7 intelligence out on the silencer. 60 gold per minute for the Rubik and Clockwork, plus 4 armor. Leshrac still level 7, not being able to spec into one. 6 strength picked up for the Axe. Looks like a kill going on here, by the way. Axe TPing in on top of the tower, though. Remy, blade mail. Remy, you're going to go down to a blade mail there, buddy. The silence is going to be there. It does manage to silence Earthshaker. He's trying to get ready for a good echo, but he's not going to find it. Wolf is going to throw down his ult, though, and it will be Ush going down indefinitely to the Clockwork coming in. Necro to get the confirmed kill, though. MDL to end up killing off Mario, and that's 5 heroes dead. Runt ended up clocking in there and locking in. Wolf and L4 to end up getting the confirmed kill. 26 and 13. 5 heroes dead yet again on the side. Can't remember the team name. It looks like they are going to go straight into the Roshan here. Weaver making sure that they benefit 100%. From all their kills, that's happening here. And Necro end up picking up the Aegis instead of L4W, which, I mean, I'm okay with that choice being made, but of course, they didn't have enough time to end up getting a massive push in here. They probably will still end up getting this mid-tier 2 tower at 18 minutes. And we lost, still trying to go for that Blink Dagger. Okay, what was I talking about? Everybody's specializations here. So it is 15 more spell lamp damage with this Ember Spirit, so he is trying to go for the Member Spirit build. And Earthshaker, only level 8, not able to spec anything, and 15 more damage available on Luna. Obviously, since Luna is an agility hero, she'll have armor automatically in there, so 4 armor is not a better choice compared to the compared to 15 more damage. Plus 40 Lewis and Beam damage, though. That would be like an Aether Cannon build indefinitely, which I think that's still a normal thing you'd end up picking up here. L4W, though, he's by himself. The Blink Dagger is going to be there. Axe is getting jumped on top of L4U here. It looks like the slow is going to be there. L4, he really wants to get out. The call, oh, the perfect silence is going to save him at the last second. L4, he wants to try and turn on this bad boy. Clockwork coming in. He's like, you're not going anywhere, Luna. You're definitely going down. Wolf to fall. L4 is just perfectly fine. He's actually going to go in Shrine and be A-OK with the rest of the game here. Mario trying to get the mid tower, but Fortification will prevent that engagement from going on. Necro, though, running around. The Invis rune's going to be popped. Bounty rune to be found, though. That means there is a hero nearby. Ush, you can't see him. I'm Invis. You can't see me, boy. Looks like the engagements are going out in the bottom tower here. MDL is getting set up for the bot lane. Will be the Aghanim Scepter. So, yes, this is a support position for Roaming Weaver, who is obviously just doing support stuff. So just look at that, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Aghanim Scepter. He wants to rearm his friends. Yeah, this is the support Weaver build. It's not a dirty build, though, either. Axe, he's going to find the call on top of Remy. Looks like the dropout's going to be there, though. The perfect ult going out. Echo Slam is there. Remy to get a double kill, one on Matt and the other on Runt. Are they going to try and find the Weaver, though? Everyone is gone. My mouse is freaking out right now. And Wolf wants to use the Shrine. Or Mario wants to use the Shrine. Everyone is not there anymore, though. MDL left. long time ago. The Aghanim Scepter is still in production. But Eternity searching the jungle to try and find the rest of the team here. We'll be the Shrine Poppage. With Ush not getting in there, actually. He's at 300. That 300 mana would have been pretty good. Would have been pretty good. Now we can actually finally talk about items here, as we have the Aghanim Scepter, as told before. Weaver is going to end up building into. Ags will be built up on the Drow as well. The Force Pike underway. Blink Dagger next on the side of the Rubik. Clockwork going in for the Aghanim Scepter as well. Leshrac trying to build an urn. And Axe, I can't exactly predict what Axe is going to do, but he just built this Force Staff. Ember Spirit, most likely yet again the Member Spirit. So he's going to go into the Boots of Travel next. Earthshaker, he just picked up the beautiful, beautiful Blink Dagger. And Luna trying to go into the Force Pike, who is now Clockwork. Getting jumped on, by the way. Remy to end up getting the kill yet again. If they keep on letting pickoffs like this happen, it will be the end of them.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And Eternity, again, just in the bot lane, trying to look for people in the jungle when the rest of the team is in the mid. So, awkward silence is going on here at 9.8k on the silencer, and it is 9.1 on the Drow, who is still going into the Aghanim Scepter here. Shadowblade going to be next on the production list. Mario picking up some more wards. Top tower, though, could be contested here as Mad trying to get a good spell steal. Necro. Oh, TP rotations all coming in here. This is going to look really bad really quickly here as the whole team is here trying to TP in. But not going to try and find any engagement. That's the whole team. Necro is not exactly ready for that engagement. Does have the Aegis, though. Soon to expire the deny. Luna will get it. Clockwork. Trying to find a cheeky hook here. But the rest of the team is ready. All ults available. Now 10,000 on the on Necro, and he is just going to TP out. Doesn't want to take the possibility of dying here, especially so close to this Shadowblade. The Aegis now expired. We'll be back in 3.5 minutes. Not that bad. Not that bad of a time. He does go for 60 gold per minute as a carry benefit instead of a support benefit. 175 health out on the Drow Ranger. Already did that one. Weaver still doing Sakuchi damage and still gold per minute and still 4 armor. 125 health picked up for the Leshrac, and the Earthshaker will go for 8 strength. Over 250 mana. Clockwork Flare going out. They can't find them. The scan is available if they want to do it. They are going to find MDL. MDL will get a blink on top of Call. It's there. He takes huge amounts of damage. Wolf is going to end up throwing down, but Mad takes the Eclipse and uses it himself. It will be Remy going down to Mad, and Mad trying to find somebody they can jump on here. Big old bomb going out here. Echo Slam is going to be there, though. We Lost is getting wailed on here, and maximum attack speed going out for Silencer will end up killing out We Lost. Axe is back and ready for action. Comeback and comeback. He's going to end up getting a buyback here, and he wants to go on Mad. Lift going to be there. Slow to follow. But will Mad be able to escape? He's TPing out. They lost him. He is out of there. It looks like Luna will end up building up all of his items. The Blink Dagger picked up on the Rubik. But that was quite an engagement. We have buybacks going out, and it's still Eternity getting a lot of the gold back, despite having a buyback in there. So not that bad of an exchange. Obviously not preferable, as Silencer did manage to get out, did not die in that engagement. And he will end up collecting his $200 for pass and go. Now he's going to end up going into the Sheep Stick, which will be able to remove the axe from his calls. But it's not going to do anything here, as Wolf is just getting ready to jump on Necro here. No Blink Dagger, no nothing. He's like, I'm going to kill you, buddy. And we Lost here. Necro trying to run as quick as possible, though. Wolf, he knows he's going to be able to kill him. Eternity. Ush is coming in as well. He wants to be there for that kill. Almost end up killing We Lost, but not quite enough there. Just another pickoff, and that was the Silencer that they wanted in the initial fight for that pickoff. They want MDL as well now. Remy, he's going up the lane. They are going up the lane. MDL He's in a bad spot here. He's going to get called off indefinitely here as the creeps are coming in. MDL throws out his... Oh, he does see them at the last second, though. Runt, meanwhile, in the mid, gets a kill on We Lost. That was not that much gold. Actually, it looks like it's still going to be MDL getting caught out. He tries to rearm. No call available there. MDL going the opposite way of where they thought. Clockwork Flare, Clockwork Hook not going to find any target. Mario, though, definitely not going to escape here. Not even a TP on him, even if he wanted to try. And now Mad actually has one of the pushing abilities from Leshrac, his ult. So, it's a very strong ability, able to clear creep waves with no problem whatsoever, though. Wolf, though, is going to get scouted out. Mad trying to get a Blink Dagger. He can't find him. No, he does see him at the last second. They don't want to go on it, though. Meanwhile, though, in the bot, everyone's getting ready for some counter kills. They're like, Clockwork is all by himself. Bomb going out. Magic damage to confirm. Runt will end up killing an off. MDL, he is revealed by some dust. There is no getting out this time, my sweet, sweet prince. You end up going down yet again. And Wolf to confirm the kill. Aether Lens will be next on the Rubik's production line here. It looks like Mad is going down to Ush. Ush coming in to get the rotation jump on him. Wasn't able to get up to the shrine to end up using it. Looks like 6 all stats is his plan here, as he already has boots to travel, so his move speed 410, pretty benefiting already. And it looks like he wants to go into the Octarine. So yeah, this is the Forever Chain Ember Spirit build, which is plus two searing chains. Wait. Now 15% cooldown reduction, plus the Octarine cooldown reduction, and it lasts for 3 seconds. They are going to try and deny this tower. Clockwork ult is available. He doesn't find anybody. Wolf is going to be able to escape. Everyone's able to escape. Escapin. So yeah, this is the member spirit build. Going here for cooldown reduction and probably just more searing chains. There's a lot of magic damage over on the side of the enemy team, though, if they want to go for magic damage absorption, but not that bad of a choice, whatever the case will be here. 13,000 running around on the silencer right now. Sheepstick nearly inches away. And the Weaver, let's see, we're going to go back into items again. Aghanim Scepter, still in production, though. Drow Ranger got the Aghanim Scepter. It's going to go into the Maelstrom, into Mjolnir. And then we have Silencer, Sheepstick, as always, Blink Dagger, the Aether Lens is next on the build list for the Rubik. Clockwork, Aghanim Scepter also underway, Leshrac now, probably going to go for the Ags himself, or Blink Dagger. Axe, what is this, he's going to go Blade Mail, 200 away. Roshan, the scan's going to be used actually, Blink Dagger picked up for the Ember Spirit. Will be the Roshan finally going down, Earthshaker, I don't know what you want to build, bro, but maybe some Arcane Boots into a mech would be the choice there. And Luna, going to go into the Manta, so it's still going to be a pushing Luna. And that's pretty much it. Now it is the Sheepstick that is built up for the Silencer, so everybody is ready for some grade A engagements going on here. Smoke is not going to be there, actually. Everyone's TPing out to go do some push-push. Go do some push-push. Yeah, no smokes available on the whole side of the Dire, so I don't know what they were planning on doing there. So, the Radiant are going to try and push out yet again. Draw Ranger working her magic with this Aghanim Scepter, multi-arrow dropping ability. Just so much damage, so much percentage of the time. 6% more precision aura, being one of the pickups here, if she wanted to pick it up. That would be 44% more damage. Percentage, so up to her choice, and then plus 25% or plus 25 marksmanship abilities. That's 105 bonus agility. Yeah, not bad. So everyone's just getting ready, most likely to defend the last tier 2 tower. The Radiant are now going to push in through the bot. Aghanim Scepter now built up for the Weaver. His tactical rearm is now available. Double Clockwork Flare going into the mid. They want to figure out where exactly the rest of the team is and what they're doing. Look at that. Look at that CS, guys. CS LOL right there. I shouldn't be talking. I'd probably be just as bad. Draw Ranger with a DD. They're like, we're pushing into this puppy. Even if this puppy doesn't want us to. We lost. Gonna stun out Draw Ranger. She is within range, and she has the Aegis, so she's just gonna keep on wailing down here as much as possible. Meanwhile, though, Runt will end up killing off Mario. Mario is dead, actually. Runt, he's gotta be a little bit careful there. They're slowly going to be out. L4U, he has Aegis if he wants to just keep on killing him. If he wants to. Ember Spirit, not gonna be able to get the chains off. It's silenced up. And Ush, is he gonna be able to get out here? He does manage to root the Drow Ranger, but Drow not exactly afraid of dying here. Tactical rearm, re-steal from Mad. He's going in. We lost. Is that gonna go down there? Echo Slam being yanked there. Ush trying to get a perfect root. There's a triple Ember Bomb here. Buyback's going to be used though. The axe is not back. You can still take this engagement. There's only a core and a half. And all of Ember's bombs are turned off right now off the other side of the game here. They find the right one. Wolf Doe does manage to pop out the... getting burned out here. Drow Ranger rooted up. Tactical rearm yet again. L4W. Runt, though, he is going to go down there. No tactical rearm for him. There's Lesh back finally, but they do manage to get the exchanges they want. No, they're going to go for more. Ush is going to end up getting silenced up here. More and more right clicks to follow. The Aegis is available. Tactical rearm yet again. Rooted up, though, he is going to end up going down for the first time. They are going to throw that down to see if they can get the kill. The stun. Stun locked forever. I don't think there is anything they could do here. The tactical rearm not available. They are going to find, actually, MDL as well, who tried to save him at the last second, but looks like they are not. Went to the wrong side. It looks like they are going to blink out. Wants to grab this regen rune and try to live longer, but regen rune, not going to be there. He is going to end up going down. He does confirm some illusion gold at the very end there, but meanwhile, Necroman, I don't know, he did not die, so he just got out pretty easily and nothing else to follow up behind it. I say that as he walks over a hostile dire ward. Remy blinks up on top of him. Blade mail is there. A lot of damage. Bing, bong, boom. It's going to be another drop down from Remy to end up getting Necroman there. Bing, bong, boom. It's going to be the BKB next on the silencer's to-do list. And Weaver, who knows? Who knows? Maybe a Deso to follow. Gem of True Sight will be picked up on the Weaver. That's his new item he picked up. Try and make sure that these sentry wards that they place in the Blitzkrieg of fights is going to be dewarded as quick as possible. Drow Ranger still trying to go for that Mjolnir. Silencer going for the BKB as always. Gem of True Sight will be picked up on the Rubik for staff. Next on the to-do list here. Just managed to pick up a book. Clockwork. Probably going to go into Blade. Oh, he already has Blade Mail. Probably going to go into more stuff that helps Blade Mail out here. He went for 15 more movement speed. So he's at 415. Leshrac does have the 4 staff. Yules is still a possible option here. And we'll be, we don't know yet. Actually, we do know. It is a Shiva's Guard. Blink is going to be used. They're going to try and find one target. But it looks like the perfect cogs are going to be there to prevent any further engagement. Perfect steel going out. No silence going to land on anybody, though. Wolf getting multiply four-staffed. Four-staffed yet again to get out there. And Wolf, nope, Clockwork is going to come on in. He's rooted up, though. He's not able to get the flares down. Global silence going to be used. Are they going to find another kill here before the TP rotates are going to be expended? Ush, he does manage to relocate to a... Spirit all the way over yon, but they are going to try and go ahead and go down the mid again. They want to force a buyback. They find Remy. Obviously Clockwork, though, really far away from Remy at this point. Not going to be able to find the counter engagement here.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And it looks like all the engagements going on here. Necroman finally going down in a team fight, just as much as they wanted, though. Remy is going to go down. Runt to get a confirmed stun out on him, though. But it looks like at the same time, Ush is going to get the drop down on Mad. Oh, is it going to be the case, though? Mad ends up getting the kill on Ush. Oh, God, that feels so bad. I would honestly hate myself after that. So Ush managing to, or Mad getting the kill at the last second, dropping down on Ush. Getting so much magic damage on top of him kills him off, and they are going to go for this shrine. And the question is, are we going to continue to see this engagement, this push down into the mid here? Axe is back, and they will be the fourth staff blink. L4U, though, is not actually going to be called. The Echo Slam going to be there. Rubik's Steel is available, but not enough mana to follow it up, though, if you wanted to do that. L4U taking quite a bit of damage, though. Is it going to be enough? L4 trying to just get a confirmed kill. He does get the rearm in time. Mario does get the stun as well, though. MDL taking quite a bit of damage, but it will be a lot more kills going out here. Axe Call finally going to go out. Will be enough. L4, all the stun is there. He's four-staffed out. He's going to get more kills. That's five dead. Eternity Call to GG. 45 and 29. Perfect. Perfect game coming out by the team. Boar, they're doing quite a good job there. Boar will end up taking game two. It's 2-0. So, that was pretty good there. And that is the end of that, folks. That is the end of the Boar versus Eternity series. This is Party PD, and thank you so much for tuning in. This is Party PD, signing off.
This is so exciting. I can't believe it's actually happening.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It all just happened so fast.
Yes. Yes, it did.
And the timing? It couldn't have been more...
perfect?
Yes. I just can't keep this inside of me anywhere. I want to show the world.
Why don't we show them right now?
This just feels so right. That looks fantastic.
We're always happy to help. Thanks for calling Bluehost.com.
Hey, who are you talking to, sweetie?
Just a Bluehost tech helping me get my website off the ground.
Train experts available to every Bluehost customer 24/7. Sign up today.
Place your bets on more than 15 esports games using the worldwide payments and even Bitcoin. We offer 24/7 support and bonuses for every new user. Best esports bets on gg.bet.
Делай ставки на более чем 15 игровых кибердисциплин с использованием всех популярных платежных систем, включая Bitcoin. Круглосуточная поддержка и бонусы новым пользователям. Делай ставки на киберспорт на gg.bet.